أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, Alhamdulillah, all praises to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for allowing us to be here and to witness and of course to watch this video. Muslim rahimakumullah, allow me to ask you this one important question. When was the last time that we revisit and relearn about our salah and our prayer? Most of us started to learn salah when we were still young, at the age of 6 or 7. And then we stop there. As we grow older and wiser, we are still practicing the same knowledge that we have gained when we were 6 and 7 years old. We tend to overlook or to revisit and relearn about our prayer. Some people may feel a bit shy, and other things is not essential and important. But the fact that is very important and crucial for us to revisit and relearn again about our solat. For example, we have 13 pillars of solat, the rukun arkanus solat. Some of that rukun fi'li, some of that rukun qawli, and some of that rukun qalbi. For example, when we recite the surah al-fatiha, how do we recite it? Is it merely in our heart, or are we able to hear what we are saying? Some people, when doing the takbiratul ihram, can't even hear the voice, just see the physical action. And this we can observe every day in a mosque or within ourselves. Salat can give us a lot of benefit. It restrains us from committing sins, the wrongdoing, and the forbidden. It allows us to be a good person, calm, tranquility, and peace. But then, that never happened to us. Why is that so? Maybe it's just because that when we're performing our salat, there's no soul in our salat. Lack of internalization, and at times we don't really understand what we have recited in the salat. Again, when was the last time that we performed salat? That salat gave a great impact to our life. Remember this Juma'ah, that we perform salat every day 5 times a day, at least 5 times, excluding the sunnah prayer. But of all these prayers that we perform, which prayer that give us the best impact? We may not have the privilege, the luxury to feel the impact every time we perform the salat, but at least we should feel once. And that can happen during our night prayer. And of course, now in the month of Ramadan, when people are performing a lot of sunnah prayer, please do revisit back our salat. Do relearn back what we need to know about our salat. And remember that when we want to be a good person, it's not a destination, it's a journey. We're going to learn, unlearn, and relearn again. And through the experience, then we can observe that, oh, actually, I missed out something on our prayer, and that makes me performing my salat without any soul. It can be through our ablution, our wudu. Maybe at times we perform our salat without a proper wudu, for example. Or maybe because of we are unable to understand what we have been recited during the salat. And that's very, very important. So now in the month of Ramadan, take this opportunity. Take this opportunity to learn the salat. As a first step, please try to understand the meaning of what the zikr that we recite during the salat. And that's very important. Understand the surah al-fatiha. And inshallah, if you take this step, inshallah, I'll tell you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will open for us the gate of wisdom. And from there, we can learn many, many things that something beyond our expectation. And inshallah, our salat will give a greater impact to our life. We become a better Muslim. We feel closer to Allah and connected to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And inshallah, we'll gain redha from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahumma amin. Ya Rabbal Alamin. Aku lukau lihazza wa astagfirullahal azimah liwalakum. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi ta'ala wabarakatuh.